just put on a great show
on every type of track.
Driving these cars, banging off of each other.
Now, oh, he gets sideways. He's off the racetrack.
There he goes, trying to make the pass. If you're a driver trying to get in, you get little opportunities like that. Watch how hard these guys are going to drive.
Checkered flag in the air.
Checkered flag there, champion.
It's time once again for East to meet West in the Graham Tire 150 for the NASCAR K&N Pro Series. We're here at Iowa Speedway. Alongside Phil Parsons, I'm Rick Allen. Down on pit road is Derek Pernasiglio. Gorgeous afternoon here in Newton, Iowa. A racetrack designed by Rusty Wallace, now one of the part owners of this facility. A great venue for the East versus West combo. Now let's go trackside to Derek Pernasiglio.
Thanks, Rick. Since 2007, the East and the West Series both converge on the Iowa Speedway for the East-West combination event. And today, Brett Moffitt has the pole. And Brett, you've won here in the past, but this is your first pole.
This is the first pole and second in a row now. We got it at Richmond, and hopefully we can win from the pole again. And man, winning here last year was unreal. I just hope we can find that feeling and end up in victory lane again tonight.
Well, he's an Iowa native. He knows this track like the back of his hand. Brett Moffitt starts on the pole tonight.
And Brett Moffitt currently sixth in the point standings after three races for the East Series. On the West side, it's Dylan Kwasniewski, who has 173 points and leads David Mayhew by six. Let's go to our Bio Blast here in the K&N Pro Series.
Hi, I'm Ryan Blaney, driver of the number 10 CORAT Repair Tape Heavy Duty Toyota. I grew up, you know, racing quarter midgets when I was 8 years old and moved to the Bandolero and Legend Car Series and eventually late models, and where I won the past championship last year and also won Phoenix in the K&N Pro Series West race last year. We want to make it up to the Cup Series eventually, and hopefully we're doing the right steps for this year, you know, running the Nationwide Series and this K&N Pro Series, so hopefully someday I can move up to the NASCAR Cup Series. I'm Ryan Blaney, and that's your K&N Bio Blast.
Pretty good looking 18-year-old here in this series.
Yeah, what an outstanding run he had. In the Nationwide debut at Richmond, he finished seventh against a stellar field.
Take a look at our starting lineup for today's race. Moffitt and Darrell Wallace Jr., both race winners already this year, are starting on the front row.
To David Mayhew back in ninth, and there's Travis Pastrana, qualified 11th, but Spahn flat-spotted his tires on his second lap. He will go to the back for the start.
Eric Holmes starts 20th in this one. He is a three-time champion of the West Series.
The Austin Dine will start in the 30th spot, just getting his start here in the East-West Series.
36 cars will start this race. C.J. Faison starting in that 36th and final spot. That's the lineup. We're about to see the green flag when we come back to Newton, Iowa at Iowa Speedway. And welcome back to Iowa Speedway and the Graham Tire 150. Cars are rolling. Let's head back to pit road and Derek Pernasiglio.
Traditionally in this race, we see a lot of strategy, whether it be tire conservation or fuel management. But this race, there's a halfway break. So everybody up and down pit road has been saying, go hard for the first 75 laps. Then around that 75 lap mark, they're going to come in, take their fuel, get fresh tires, and go hard for the next 75 laps to the end.
Field all in line. Once again, out in front, two race winners as the green flag goes in the air. Brett Moffitt, Darrell Wallace Jr. bringing the field to the green.
Nice jump by Brett Moffitt. Darrell Wallace Jr. will settle in second.
Both of those two drivers have won from starting on the pole this year, so we'll see if Brett Moffitt has that opportunity once again here in Iowa.
Awfully strong car. As Derek reported earlier, he's a former winner of this race.
See that nine of Chase Elliott mired in the middle of the pack.
Side-by-side racing already. Sergio Pena, the one car, pulls up to the inside of Darrell Wallace Jr.
One of the great things about this racetrack, there are so many racing grooves that you can run around.
Inside, outside, middle, there's plenty of places to go.
And right now, Sergio Pena on the inside of Darrell Wallace Jr., battling for that second spot. Pena has the advantage as they come through three and four and out onto the front stretch.
Had him clear for just a moment, did not pull up in front of him. That allows Darrell to fight back on the outside. Three wide behind him.
Very close, almost some contact there between Sergio Pena and Darrell Wallace Jr. Wallace Jr. drops back into the third spot now.
See Ryan Blaney, that yellow car, he runs in fourth. There's Corey LaJoie, the 07, he runs fifth.
69 of Kyle Larson.
Some of the numbers are going to be different,
yeah.
Rick. Unlike what we're used to seeing because of the East-West combo, some of the guys have the same numbers. Car owner points in each division is what dictated who got the number.
Brian Ortiz on the outside in the number four. trying to work around that 69. Kyle Larson able to take that spot. Now they're single file. Corey LaJoie just in front of that four of Brian Ortiz.
See Ryan Gifford in the two car join that battle. Let's take a look at some of the storylines for today's race. You want to be able to arc that car into the turns. You want a nice wide arc so you have that car aimed in the center of the corner so it'll turn. And you also have to be very careful and negotiate that bump over the tunnel over in one and two. You have to have the car aimed the right direction, and you have to take care of that right front tire. Over 2,300 pounds of pressure on that right front tire here at Iowa.
Lean on the right front quite a bit. And that's, as a race car driver, you've got to feel a little more comfort if you're able to lean on that right front, don't you? I mean, as far as handling?
Yeah, without a doubt. But you're on it so long here in the front straightaway with a constant arc, you stay on that right front tire. You don't give that right front tire any time to relax other than the short space down the backstretch right there.
Side-by-side action. Chase Elliott looking to the inside of that 49 of Jason Bowles.
Jason Bowles, a former champion in the West Series, also won the Toyota All-Star Showdown last time we had it.
Bowles, that 2009 West Series champion. Brings 9 wins on his resume into this event.
Right behind the 51 car of Carlos Iaconelli. Carlos has done double duty. He's also a full-time racer in the East Series, but ran Phoenix earlier this year, had a great sixth-place finish.
Carlos Iaconelli out of Brazil. 5 countries represented in this field.
Chase Elliott coming off his best finish of his career at Richmond. Had a great battle there at Richmond with Brett Moffitt. Come up just short.
Yeah, great battle also with the 07 of Corey LaJoie. He ended up third in that race. Chase Elliott finished second. That was his career best. And Moffitt went on to get the win.
Nice run off the top of the racetrack for Ryan Blaney there around the outside of Brian Ortiz.
Good battle for fourth. 4 cars all involved in it. Blaney has the advantage. Now to the inside, Brian Ortiz trying to take that spot away.
See Corey LaJoie, the 07 white car on the outside of the 69. That's Kyle Larson.
So again, 4 cars battling for the fourth spot right now. Side by side, they stay. Now you see Corey LaJoie moving up on the outside of that 4 of Brian Ortiz.
Just after that battle, you see the 47 car of Cale Connolly. Cale started back in the 13th spot, and he's made his way up into that battle.
Sergio Pena and Darrell Wallace Jr. running well up toward the front. Sergio Pena starting this race in the 3rd position. Darrell Wallace Jr. again was on the front row, started 2nd. And Brett Moffitt has decided to check out on this field early on.
Been a tough start to the season for Sergio Pena. So much promise last year, won 3 times. Right now his last race out at Richmond was his only top 10 finish of the year, 9th.
Yeah, actually he had two finishes outside the top 20 in his first 2 races, which were uncharacteristic of Sergio Pena.
See, Corey LaJoie now has moved out in front of that battle for 4th. He's going to bring Ortiz with him.
And we're seeing Ryan Blaney, it looks like, falling off the pace now as he starts to drop back.
There's that 47 of Cale Connolly joining that battle.
Connolly behind the 10 now. We'll see if Blaney can keep the momentum going and go forward, but it looks as though that 69... Kyle Larson's going to be able to take the position away from Blaney, and Blaney continues to drop spots.
Looks like Conley's going to follow Ryan Blaney now on the top of the racetrack. Now he's going to dive to the inside.
So many different lines. You talked about arcing the turn or arcing your entry into the turns there.
You could see the bump over the tunnel there as those cars went through the center of 1 and 2. Nice move by Cale Connolly to get by Ryan Blaney. David Hyder, who has a lot of experience in all the platforms of NASCAR, from the Cup Series, Nationwide Series, Truck Series, is a crew chief on that car, really doing a nice job.
Scheduled to go 150 laps. We're on 14 of that 150. Again, a halfway break at lap 75.
Brett Moffitt has it going his way right now. Doesn't even really hardly see anybody in his mirror.
Brett Moffitt almost is straight away in front of 2nd place.
You just wonder, again, we're going to have a halftime break at lap 75, so you can abuse your tires now if you need to, because you know you're going to take them off at lap 75.
Moffitt, Wallace Jr., Pena, LaJoie, and Ortiz, your top 5 here in Iowa. Welcome back to Iowa Speedway, Newton, Iowa, for the Graham Tire 150, East versus West. Again, it's the 4th race of 14 for the East Series. and the fifth race of 15 races for the West Series.
Good battle for the four spot there. Sergio Pena, the one on the outside. Brian Ortiz, the four on the inside.
Right behind him, Kyle Larson in that 69. Larson's been looking good. He's got Cale Conley behind him in the 47. They stay side by side for the fourth spot. Pena on the outside has the advantage now as he pulls in front of Brian Ortiz.
Get a good run from the outside. You get that momentum built up. A little tougher from the inside, getting the throttle down.
He stayed in the middle of the track through the corner, and that allowed Brian Ortiz in the four to make up that ground that he had just taken away from him. So Pena still working it, and sideways, Brian Ortiz slides, has to catch it. No contact made.
You saw those cars hop over that bump over the tunnel there in one and two. It seems to get worse each and every year, and it seems like every racetrack we go to that has a tunnel, which most of them do, we always have a bump over the tunnel.
Kyle Larson, he's been able to get by Brian Ortiz now, takes that spot away. So Larson moves up into the fifth spot.
Now Pena drives to the inside of a lap car. That's the 41 of Darrell Haar,
one of the West drivers.
Darrell giving these guys plenty of room.
So Sergio Pena in the one has been able to move back up in front of that 69. Been a big battle, though, for that fourth spot. Pena holding on to it.
Ortiz got a little bit loose back there. See, Corey LaJoie now has moved up to the back bumper of the 18 of Darrell Wallace Jr. in a battle for second.
Darrell Wallace Jr. holding on to that spot. Corey LaJoie making a charge for it. Again, Brent Moffitt out in front of these two.
Oh, and into the wall. The 18 of Darrell Wallace Jr. blows the right front and into the wall hard.
Very obvious that the right front tire failed on that 18 car as he got down to the corner and made significant contact.
That car went straight into the wall. Very hard hit for Darrell Wallace Jr.
That's a good view of Darrell right there. You can see that he's stunned by that impact. And even though we have safer barriers, Rick, that doesn't mean that you don't hit hard. And you can tell by the damage to that Toyota.
Take another look at what happened. Running second.
Was not expecting this at all. Right as he loads up that right front tire, that car is going to turn about 40 degrees to the right and hard into the outside wall.
A helpless feeling for a driver when the right front goes.
Another view. Boy, don't you know Corey LaJoie was glad he wasn't on the outside of Darrell Wallace Jr.
Does a car ever give you any warning when a right front's about to go?
Not really, unless maybe you can have a little bit of a vibration, but you see Darrell Wallace Jr. still running a good pace because he's up in the second spot.
Running in the second spot, Darrell Wallace Jr. into the wall hard, bringing out our first caution. Let's go to Derek Pernasiglio.
Well, you can see the heavy right front damage to the number 18 machine. Darrell Wallace took a hard shot into the wall, but did it give any indication that the tire was going?
No, not at all. I mean, we weren't even abrasive on it in practice or even qualifying. It's just a little tight, picking up the throttle in the race, but no signs at all. I don't understand it. I have a flat at Bristol, flat in practice at Richmond, a flat in the race at Richmond, a blown tire here. I don't know. I don't get it.
Let's see if wasn't for bad luck, you wouldn't have luck at all. And that's what Darrell Wallace Jr. is describing to us. He's had a lot of bad luck.
Big weekend for him, too, making his nationwide debut here at Iowa this weekend.
Green flag back in the air, back out front. It's Brett Moffitt. We'll see if he's able to check out once again on the field, as he had done since the drop of the initial green flag.
Looks like Sergio Pena was able to take advantage of that inside line on the restart to grab the second spot.
Side by side, racing for position on the inside, that 51. Of Carlos Iaconelli. Now they're three wide. Travis Pastrana working to the inside as well. Inside of Andrew Smith in the 62.
Nice pickup by Travis Pastrana. Remember, we reported he had to start at the back because of spinning on his second lap of qualifying and made his move up here well into the top 20.
Travis Pastrana looking really good at Richmond until he had some issues late in the race. Dropped him back to a 23rd place finish at Richmond. Corey LaJoie on the outside, the 69 of Kyle Larson on the inside.
These guys have battled just about since the beginning of this race. Corey was able to move out in front of that battle for fourth a few laps ago, but the caution flag bunched him up.
Sergio Pena running in the second spot. Third now is the 69 of Kyle Larson. fourth Corey LaJoy, and now he's got his hands full. Looks like Corey LaJoy slowing on the racetrack. Kyle Conley goes by.
Yeah, Kale just shot by him, and Brian Ortiz is trying to do the same thing. It looked like Corey just backed off a little bit, maybe. Now he's pulling to the inside. He's got a problem of some sort.
Got to be something wrong with that race car as he goes down to the apron. The 07, Corey LaJoy, after running in the top five, looks as though he's going to be coming to pit road.
Caution flag is out now. Looks like Eric Holmes has had a right front tire issue. Corey LaJoy is making his way to pit road. Saw that the caution flag was out. Stayed on the racetrack.
And there's some damage to the 23. We see the 97 getting turned around. Jesse Little in the 97, the 23 of Sam Hunt.
Look at all the damage to that Napa Toyota for Eric Holmes.
And the right front tire down. Once again, we saw that with Darrell Wallace Jr. The right front went away. A lot of damage to the 23. Sam Hunt bringing that off the racetrack now.
Yeah, front and rear damage for Sam Hunt. See if we can see. Look at the top of our screen there. Ooh.
It looked like another right front going down.
Another right front tire going down, and Eric Holmes at the exit of the corner.
So the hard left turn into the garage area. Sam Hunt will have to head in there after extensive damage to the 23. Stay with us. More of the Graham Tire 150 here on Speed. And welcome back. Green flag in the air from Iowa Speedway. The Graham Tire 150 continues. Brett Moffitt out in front in the 11. Sergio Pena in the 1 trying to hold on to the second spot.
Three wide battling back here. David Mayhew, the 17 car on the inside. Now David's made his way up into the top 10. David has been the West winner twice in this combination, as well as winning a West-only race. So he has three wins to his credit here at Iowa.
And both series, the East and the West, will get points based upon how they finish against their competition in this race.
As well as a win if you're the top finishing East or West driver.
Side by side for position back here, the 0-3. Dylan Kwasniewski. Now you got a battle for the fourth spot. Ryan Gifford and Cale Conley. Conley on the inside, Gifford on the outside.
Well, Cale was able to drive that car hard down on the corner and able to make it stick.
Phil, you talked about leaning too much on the right front. Are we maybe seeing a little of that out of Cale Conley right now?
Well, it seems like he is hard on that right front tire, especially on that pass now. And maybe he's not using that right front tire as much when he's normal racing, but he had to make that pass. He wanted to clear that car, and he maybe used a little bit right there. But you know, a lot of times these guys, they can feel it. We heard Darrell Wallace say that he wasn't able to feel any problem whatsoever.
Ryan Gifford and Brian Ortiz battling for position. Let's go back down to Derek.
Kyle Larson has only been racing in the K&N Pro Series a short time, but he does have laps at this racetrack in a USAC open wheel car. He's moved into second right now. He's putting on quite a performance, and as a matter of fact, he's getting used to this world of stock car racing pretty good. He won a late model race in New Smyrna Speedway during Speed Weeks in Daytona in February.
Kyle Larson takes second away from Sergio Pena, now sets his sights on that 11 of Brett Moffitt.
Yeah, great start to the season for Kyle Larson. He's had two top 10 finishes already, including a fourth last time out at Richmond.
Side by side, Pastrana on the inside. That 0-3 of Dylan Kwasniewski on the outside.
Until we watched Dylan Kwasniewski run extremely well in the West Series. So for Travis Pastrana, who started all the way to the back, be up here racing with Kwasniewski right now, a nice run so far for Travis.
Dylan Kwasniewski with three wins in the West Series. Pastrana able to get past Kwasniewski now for that position.
There's Travis Miller in the 16 car. That's another car out of the X Team Racing stable. He moves to the inside of Kwasniewski.
Kwasniewski, after starting in the 17th spot, trying to hold on to 14th right now, but the battle is on between he and Travis Miller.
You see his teammate Greg Persley right behind that side-by-side battle. Greg won the West portion of this race here last year with a top five finish overall.
Greg Persley, a champion of the West Series as well from last year after six wins in the 2011 campaign.
See Ryan Blaney move down to block the advance of the 99 of Pastrana. That's Andrew Smith, the 62 car on the outside of Blaney.
Pastrana seems to be picking things up in a stock car already. It's a very limited schedule that he's been able to run, but he is learning with every turn of the wheel.
Oh, another problem right in front of our cameras.
That's David Mayhew, the 17 car. Another right front tire issue.
Mayhew slams into the outside wall, and look at the damage to that car.
Well, it looks very much like Eric Holmes' car and Darrell Wallace Jr.'s car. So, I'm telling you, if I'm a crew chief now on pit road and I see this happen for the third time, I'm going to be alerting my driver, please stay off that right front tire.
Mayhew is credited with 3 wins here at Iowa Speedway, but it doesn't look to be in the cards for him today.
Let's keep an eye on it here. You see him right at the bottom of our screen. Tire goes down, absolutely nothing a driver can do.
So the third caution comes out in the Graham Tire 150. Mayhew walks to the ambulance, and we'll be back with more. Welcome back to Iowa Speedway. We've moved ahead in our broadcast because of time constraint. Oh, a battle for the 7th spot here between Gifford and Pena. And a little smoke out of the left front tire of Ryan Gifford.
Yeah, a little contact right there between the 1 and the 2, and they make more contact. Look at Sergio Pena shaking his fist at Ryan Gifford. They were teammates last year at Revolution Racing.
There's some damage to the left front of the 2 of Ryan Gifford, and we're seeing some tire rub there, some smoke coming out of the 2, and right behind that 2, the 10 of Ryan Blaney.
Well, Ryan Gifford has decided he wants that spot. He made contact with the right side of his car. Now they're trying to do it again.
Side by side for position. On the outside, Sergio Pena in the 1 has him cleared. Here comes Gifford now on the bottom of the racetrack.
Remember, we're just a couple laps before the halftime break here. Now Ryan Blaney's going to take advantage and get by Gifford on the outside.
Ryan Blaney trying to take that spot away. Gifford charging on the bottom of the racetrack, trying to hold on to this position.
What a great side-by-side battle here. Blaney has a spot for now, but Gifford's been able to drive really, really hard down into the corner.
As you mentioned, coming up on the halftime break at lap 75. NASCAR officials will throw the yellow flag. They'll make their way onto pit road. But until then, they haven't decided who's going to have what position between Gifford and Ryan Blaney and Sergio Pena out in front. Pena in the 1, trying to hold on to this position. Again, they were battling for the 7th spot.
It looks like the last lap they're battling on here instead of a last lap before a halftime break.
So Pena holds on to 2nd, the battle for 8th just behind him. Gifford throwing it in there hard, trying to take that spot away from Ryan Blaney.
Blaney thought about going to the outside of Pena.
As they cross the stripe, just past the halfway point of this race. Still no caution yet as far as the halfway point in the break. Here comes Blaney to the outside, trying to take that spot away from Pena.
He got his nose to the outside. Now the caution flag does come out. They will revert back to the previous lap, so Pena will get that spot back.
So this caution coming out for the halfway break. Everyone will make their way onto pit road. Brett Moffitt, your race leader from the drop of the initial green flag, and he hasn't been challenged up to this point.
An outstanding run so far for Brett Moffitt. You know, all these crew chiefs are going to want to look at that right front tire that are on these cars, see if there's any damage. We've seen a lot of right front tire issues so far with 3 of our top competitors.
3 cautions that have come out have all been because of right front issues. You see the green flag to pit road being opened. So the field will make its way onto pit road and to the attention of their crews.
Just adjustments that you would make on a normal pit stop is all that these guys will be able to do.
So the field making their way onto pit road, we have a chance to talk with race leader Brett Moffitt, and that will be Derek Pernasiglio chatting with him.
Brett Moffitt leads at the halfway break. Brett, you've got a fast car. Kyle Larson is real fast behind you. Have you showed your hand just yet?
The last couple laps there, we ran real hard just to see what it'd have if we get in a racing scenario at the end of the day. And, man, these guys did a great job. We're going to fine-tune on it just a little bit more, and hopefully that 69 will have nothing for us, but he's done a great job all day, too.
Talking about Kyle Larson, started in 5th place, currently running 2nd behind that 11 of Brett Moffitt. When we come back, the green flag goes back up in the air after this halfway break. Welcome back. Field coming to the green flag. It's in the air. Moffitt leading Kyle Larson to the stripe. It's Brett Moffitt up front. Kyle Larson running 2nd. Cale Conley has made his way up into 3rd spot.
Chase Elliott restarts in the 4th spot. Cale Conley now moves to the inside of Kyle Larson,
trying to take that position away. Conley to the inside. That's a battle for second. Just behind him, side by side for position as well. See Ryan Gifford in the two. He was battling for seventh earlier. And now a little wiggle out of the 51 of Carlos Iaconelli.
A big wiggle, and it allows these guys to go four wide for just a moment.
Amazing that this track will allow four wide, but it is a wide sweeping racetrack.
See Dylan Kwasniewski gets the advantage on that group that was battling four wide there for a moment. There's Ben Kennedy, the 96 car. Ben has top 10 finishes in each of the three races so far in the East Series.
Chad Bode on his outside in the 98. Just behind them, the 49, driven by Jason Bowles on the inside of that 83 of Dylan Prisnell.
See the 46 of Brandon Godovic, top five finishes in his last two starts.
He's really come around. He and his father, Rick Godovic, obviously started racing last year quite a bit, and then Rick has got a limited schedule now, but we see Brandon in virtually every race, and he has done extremely well.
And Sam Hunt that we saw earlier had an incident involved. He comes out of the same stable as well.
Two and three wide once again to the outside, the 83 of Dylan Prisnell trying to take the position away.
Iaconelli sideways again, right in the middle of two cars.
We've seen that 51 get sideways quite a few times already. 14 of Daniel Suarez now going by the 51 on the inside.
Daniel was able to get to victory lane in his native Mexico for his first time in his career just a few days ago.
The 51 of Carlos Iaconelli, a handful. Now we see the 07 making his way by.
Three wide racing behind Corey LaJoy in that 07.
62 on the inside of Andrew Smith.
That's Eddie McDonald in the 7 car. We're used to seeing Eddie in the 71, but again, because of owner points, Eddie had to run the 7 this week. There's a battle for 5th. Pena the 1, Larson in the 69, and Pastrana in the 99.
Impressive run for Travis Pastrana, looking to break into the top 5 if he can. Pena holding on to that 5th spot.
We talked about Darrell Wallace Jr. doing double duty here to make his nationwide debut. Travis Pastrana will also run the nationwide race here in Iowa this weekend.
Now Pastrana currently running in the 7th spot. Just in front of him, that 69 by Kyle Larson. Now he's looking to go by Larson, work to the inside. Here's the difference between race leader Brett Moffitt and Cale Conley in that 47.
Rick, this is about as close as we've seen anybody get to Brett Moffitt this entire race here with 66 laps to go.
Brett Moffitt said he ran the last few laps of before the halfway break as hard as he could, thinking that he had enough for Cale Conley if Conley was able to battle with him. Let's go back to pit road and Derek.
And guys, what a difference a year makes for the number 47 of Cale Conley. Last year, he didn't appear on anybody's radar. He was pretty much an also-ran. This year, he's put together some real strong runs. He was at Greenville Pickens running up front until a wiring problem put him out. He missed Richmond because they destroyed their primary car in testing. This is the backup car that they have that they're racing here right now. He's got veteran crew chief David Hyder up on the pit box. Plus, he's got technical support from JTG Racing.
He does have a lot of help behind him, and he's showing right now that he is a talented young race car driver. Sideways, the 0-3 of Dylan Kwasniewski trying to get to the inside of Ryan Gifford.
He never backed off, though. He was able to get to the inside of Ryan Gifford. Right now, Dylan Kwasniewski is the leader of the West Brigade.
Sideways again. He works his way through 1 and 2 and down the backstretch.
He's a little bit of a gap up in front of this two car of Ryan Gifford. Dylan Kwasniewski wants to get this spot and go chase down that group up in front of them.
A little wiggle out of Travis Miller just behind these two as they continue to battle for the position.
See Chad Bote, the 98 on the inside, moves alongside Brandon Godovic in the 46.
Those two say side by side. Kwasniewski sideways as he goes through 1 and 2 again.
Ooh!
Travis Miller in the 16. A little shaken up there.
Yeah, Travis had a little bit of room, fortunately, between those cars. Gathered it back in.
Now as he's got it back going the right direction, Chad Bote and Brandon Godovic both in front of him.
See, Ben Kennedy moves to the inside. Ben's in the 96 to the inside of Jason Bowles, former series champion in the West. Actually racing out of the East, though, for this race.
Ben Kennedy working the bottom of the racetrack through 3 and 4.
Michael Self in the 21. First time we've seen Michael in this race. West Series competitor.
Back behind this bunch, the 14 of Daniel Suarez in that white and blue, number 14.
Another one of the cars out of the X-Team stable. See Corey LaJoy right behind them.
Corey LaJoy not on the lead lap. Has had a tough race here after such an impressive performance in Richmond last race out.
Yeah, second and third last two races for Corey LaJoy, Greenville and Richmond. But not going to be his day here, it doesn't look like.
Yeah, definitely not working out that way for him. That bump, so profound when they go through one and two and just over where the tunnel is.
Yeah, Ben Kennedy drove down in that corner, hit that bump, and this car went straight. He gathered it back in. Daniel Suarez now to his inside. Michael Self, the 21, right behind Ben Kennedy.
And Michael Self, one of the West Series drivers. Kwasniewski still leading the West Series brigade. See a little sparks out of Corey LaJoy, 07, as he went over the bumps.
Hard racing here with just inside of 60 laps to go. Remember, no more halftime break. Three wide.
Four position. On the inside, Daniel Suarez in the 14, Ben Kennedy right in the middle, and on the outside, the 21 of Michael Self. Looks as though Suarez is going to take the spot here in Iowa. And we've moved ahead in our broadcast. 24 laps of racing to go.
Brett Moffitt still out front, as he has been this entire race. There's Dylan Kwasniewski right there, the 0-3. That's the battle for 11th. Brandon Godovic, the 46.
Kyle Conley has lost some of the ground that he was able to keep up with Moffitt. Oh. And into the wall, the 51.
Carlos Iaconelli looks like another right front tire, Rick.
You know, when we saw Carlos Iaconelli, looks like he was struggling to get the handle on that race car. And this time, as you mentioned, it looks like the right front goes down and he smacks the wall hard.
But it looked like that car was loose. It looked like he wouldn't have been abusing the right front tire. But there's no question right there after looking at that car that it was another right front tire issue.
Hard into the outside wall. And Carlos Iaconelli, as we take another look out of his race car.
There it goes, the hard right once that tire lets go.
And straight into the wall.
It just illustrates how much pressure is on those right side tires. And when something like that happens and you deflate, that's how hard those things turn right.
Field reset, green flag back in the air. Moffitt with another good restart this time. Chase Elliott able to take over second away from Conley as they fight for position behind him, and sideways was the 4 of Brian Ortiz.
And a great save by the 10 of Ryan Blaney. He and the 4 made contact. Ryan was going around the outside. Terrific save.
Ryan has it going straight once again. Looking to the inside for position now. We see the 4 of Brian Ortiz on the outside of that 7 of Eddie McDonald.
There's Brandon Godovic, the 46. Dylan Presnell in the 83 right behind him. 15 laps to go now. Time to make it happen.
2 and 3 wide, fighting 4 spots on the racetrack. Moffitt still has the lead, but now it's Chase Elliott that's chasing him.
Cale Conley lost that second spot to Chase Elliott.
On the restart, so Elliott has second. Cale Conley drops back to the third position. They're side by side. That's the 69 of Kyle Larson on the outside of the 21 of Michael Self.
Remember, the 26 of Greg Pursley is the leading West contender right now, right out in front of that battle.
And we see Conley has taken over the second spot once again from Chase Elliott. Now side by side, Sergio Pena on the outside, Travis Pastrana on the inside.
You know, Travis Pastrana has run extremely well this year. Had a great run going at Greenville. Got turned around there while running in the top 5. Really coming into his own here with no more experience than he has.
A little bit of damage to the right rear of that 99, but no worse for the wear as he's been able to take 4th away from Sergio Pena. So Pastrana up into the 4th position.
See Ryan Blaney running that high side. Ryan's been able to make some passes from the top side here. There's that battle for 2nd. Cale Conley, the 47. Chase Elliott, the 9.
Your top 3. Brett Moffitt still out in front in the 11, but the gap has closed now as the laps wind down. Just 12 laps to go when they cross the stripe. 11 remain. Moffitt in front of Cale Conley and Chase Elliott.
Remember, Cale Conley, Chase Elliott, neither one of these guys has been to victory lane yet in the series. Both of them extremely hungry for a win, as well as Brett Moffitt. Certainly hungry too, even though he's been a winner in the series.
Brett Moffitt looking to go back-to-back wins after he won Richmond the last race out, so he has 8 wins to his career, trying to make it 9 tonight. and he has been the dominant race car.
He certainly has. With 10 laps to go, Ryan Blaney is able to make the pass on Sergio Pena. Remember, Ryan is a winner in the West Series at Phoenix last November.
Ryan Blaney in front of Sergio Pena. Blaney has taken over the fifth spot. Pastrana running fourth just behind this group of three. Moffitt, Conley, and Elliott, your top three. 9 laps of racing to go from Iowa.
You know, right now, Cale Conley is trying to muster up enough to get up there to race the 11 of Moffitt. Moffitt really hasn't been challenged this entire race, Rick. This is as close as anyone's been.
Not one race car has been beside that 11 of Brett Moffitt, with the exception of the restarts. Only on restarts, when someone is on the outside of the 11 of Brett Moffitt, that's the closest they've been. But now Conley has closed the gap inside of 8 laps to go. Conley on the back bumper of that 11.
I have to believe if Brett Moffitt was going to save anything, he would be showing it right now. But I'm telling you, Cale Conley's all over the back bumper.
When they come up to the stripe, it'll be 7 laps remaining. You've got Moffitt right behind him, the 47, looking to the inside. Cale Conley going for the lead as they cross the stripe, side by side.
A great run through the center of the corner allowed Cale Conley to get beside him. Now they're going to go over the bump.
Conley sideways, sliding through 1 and 2, still has the advantage down the backstretch. Here comes the 11. They bump as they go back down to the backstretch and into 3.
Conley drives it in there hard, slides up the racetrack a little bit, sideways again.
These two are side by side for the lead. Chase Elliott running in the third spot just behind them. 2 laps now, they've been side by side.
Oh, contact!
The 47 into the 11. The 9 goes by. Chase Elliott takes the lead. Moffitt sideways, but he's able to save it.
Pastrana's going to get by Moffitt. Here comes Blaney to get drive by Moffitt.
Moffitt's night. Unfortunate incident coming out of 2, and now Chase Elliott, your race leader. 5 laps of racing to go.
Let's take a look at what happened here. You watch Cale Conley. He gets a little bit loose. They make a little bit of contact. He drove it in there real hard, got to the bump, slid up the racetrack into Moffitt. A great save by Moffitt.
Chase Elliott takes advantage of those two cars racing hard for the lead, and Elliott takes over the top spot. And now Elliott coming out of turn number 4. It'll be 4 laps of racing to go. Oh, coming out of turn number 2. The 96 of Ben Kennedy hard into the wall. That brings out the caution once again.
Another right front tire issue, Rick. Hard contact for Ben Kennedy. There's a damage right there. Look how it narrows that car up.
Ben Kennedy, you see him taking the steering wheel off of that race car, and we'll start to unstrap. Let's take another look.
Just absolutely nothing a driver can do there. He's running right behind the 0-3 of Dylan Kwasniewski, and man, look at the damage.
Hard contact, and Ben Kennedy will bring that race car to a halt. And this means we're going to go a little extra from Iowa. Chase Elliott out in front of Cale Conley when the green flag comes back out. So our first attempt at a green-white checker finish in the Graham Tire 150 from Iowa Speedway. Pace car is going to make the hard left turn, leaving the field in Chase Elliott's hands. He's on the bottom of the racetrack, on the ends outside. Cale Conley in the 47. Green flag back in the air.
A lot of damage to the right front corner of that 47 car, Rick, from that contact before.
And sparks flying from behind the 47. Looks like he might have an issue. Doesn't have anything for Chase Elliott right now as they rock it down the backstretch.
Pastrana got sideways, able to save it. Look at Moffitt go to the inside of Pena.
Travis Pastrana just in front of Pena, the 47 of Cale Conley, high on the racetrack. This time by, white flag in the air, one more time around for Chase Elliott.
Look at Ryan Blaney go to the inside of the 47. A lot of damage on that 47. Ryan Blaney is going for second.
Blaney to the inside. He takes second away from the 47 of Cale Conley. Running in the fourth spot, the 99 of Travis Pastrana. But coming through 3 and 4, Chase Elliott will see the checkered flag for the first time in his career. Elliott wins at Iowa.
And I don't think that's the last time we're ever going to see Elliott win a race.
Chase Elliott, one of the Hendrick development drivers, wins his first race. Hard contact for the 21 of Michael Sell. Another right front tire goes down.
Inside of the start-finish line, and he cuts down a right front tire. Does a lot of damage to that 21 car.
Michael Self does cross the start-finish line, so he will get credited with his finish, but What a run for the 9 of Chase Elliott. Was able to take advantage of Cale Conley and Brett Moffitt as they were battling for the lead. They got loose into the wall, goes the 11 of Brett Moffitt. Cale Conley drops back. Elliott takes the lead and holds on to it.
First NASCAR win for Chase Elliott. Came awfully close. Richmond, we thought he had maybe a win. Finished second there, but an outstanding job by this team.
16-year-old out of Dawsonville, Georgia. Chase Elliott celebrating win number one in the K&N Pro Series. And you think Bill taught him how to do that?
I don't think so. I don't think so. That's all him.
I don't remember Bill doing a lot of burnouts after his wins. Great win for Chase Elliott. We'll hear from him next. It's the first win for a manufacturer other than Toyota since Ty Dillon at Gresham in 2010. 17 straight races, and now a Chevrolet is in victory lane. Let's go to Derek.
Well, he's won in every single type of race car that he has competed in his entire life, and it was just a matter of time before Chase Elliott picks up his first ever NASCAR K&N Pro Series win, and it comes in the biggest stage here at the Iowa Speedway. Chase, congratulations.
I appreciate it, man. I just want to say thanks to the fans. Always an awesome crowd here at Iowa, and I just can't thank my crew enough, and Lance and everybody that worked so hard. We were behind the beginning of the season, kind of got back on track, and man, all this is thanks to Aaron's. HendrickCars.com, all everybody behind us. I want to thank Mr. Hendrick, mom and dad, and just everybody that supported me, man. It's taken a little while to get this, but I feel like we're definitely on the right track to running really well, and man, it's just awesome. I can't describe it.
That ice water is awfully cold, but what did you think when the two leaders, Cale Conley and Brett Moffitt, got together?
That was my chance right there. That was my chance to get by him, and I don't know if I'd have been able to have done anything with him before that. But I was going to give it one last good shot there about the time that happened. And, fortunately, it kind of worked out, and we'll definitely take it. But, man, owe this one to the man upstairs and everybody behind us. This is awesome.
Cale Conley and Ryan Blaney were very strong in that late race caution. Did you get nervous when that yellow came out?
Yes and no. I felt like our car was pretty good on those short runs. We were a little bit tight to start with, and I thought if we were just tight enough, we could try to get away from him for a lap. So had a good restart and got out front, and it worked out.
Well, guys, he picks up the biggest win of his career. Chase Elliott brings it home to Iowa victory lane.
Win number one for Chase Elliott, definitely very big. Take a look at the results from this one. Blaney comes home second. Cale Conley, and a career best for Travis Pastrana, finishes fourth.
Dylan Kwasniewski will end up eighth. He will be the top finishing West regular and get a win for that.
Gets credited with the win. He'll get the points for it, as well as they've completed now 5 of the 15 races of the 2012 season. This is the fourth race for the East Series. You see Ryan Gifford, Jesse Little, Alex Kennedy.
And remember, we'll be back here again for another combo race.
2 times this year in Iowa, so an impressive run for a lot of different drivers. One of those being Ryan Blaney. He's with Derek.
Well, Ryan Blaney continues to impress in the K&N Pro Series and in the Nationwide Series. Pretty much everything that you've driven. How was your run tonight?
Well, we qualified good, qualified fourth, and we left the cow cover on at the beginning of the race, which lets air get into the carburetor, and that cuts down power if there's no air going to it. So that's why we went backwards in the beginning. And we come down pit road, that first caution, we took it off, and then we kind of made our way forward. And, on that pit stop, I think we were ninth, and we were way too loose. We over-adjusted, and we were really good at the end. I think we could have had a shot. Me and Travis were really good. We were kind of running down that lead pack, just kind of ran out of time. And I think if we could have had about 5 laps at the end, we would have had something for Chase. But it's good to run second to him. I picked no other person to run second to.
Ryan Blaney comes home with a runner-up finish in Iowa.
We have to talk to Dave about leaving that cover on the cowl.
Take a look at our point standings. This is your top 10 on the east side. Chase Elliott now leading the points by 21 over Moffitt. Larson Godovic in the top 5.
See, Kwasniewski now opens up his lead a little bit over his teammate Persley. Now has 15-point lead over Greg.
Top 10 separated by 67 points in the West Series. Well, the next race in the East Series, Bowman Gray Stadium in Winston-Salem. That's Thursday, June 7th. A great one here, side-by-side racing and a lot of right front tire issues. See Darrell Wallace Jr. a little sore after that contact. The battle was side-by-side for the lead, and then
Chase Elliott decides to slip on the inside and take over that top spot. Chase Elliott winning his first race in the K&N Pro Series. And Dad Bill, I'm sure, extremely proud.
This copyrighted telecast may not be reproduced, retransmitted, or used in any form without the authorized written consent of NASCAR Broadcasting. NASCAR would like to thank all of our loyal fans for your continued support, and we hope you enjoyed today's broadcast.